this year's winners are Dyson Parson, if you'll come up please.
Wow, man.
Ms. Tamara Johnson for inviting me here to speak to you guys this evening. She called me.
You really won't be in
this. She asked me, and I didn't hesitate to accept the invitation. So I just want to thank you and your committee for thinking of me, or thinking of me, to come and speak to you guys tonight. But first thing I want to do, I understand that this is a Special Olympics banquet for the student athletes, but at this time, I would like to recognize someone else. Now, I have two daughters myself. It's already a challenge raising them. So I know for you guys, they have to put in the extra support. I know it's a challenge for you guys too. So at this time, if you are a parent of one of the Special Olympic athletes, please stand so we can give you a round of applause, please.
Way up there, baby. You're down there, boy. Come on, baby. You are down there. You ain't no parent, boy. You ain't got no kids.
25 kids.
You ain't got no 25 kids.
Okay.
What's
up? I don't have long. So I'm going to give you a quick biography before I get into some other things. So I'm going to start in middle school. In middle school, I was a bench warmer. We had four teams. I was on the fourth team.
You ain't here.
That means I didn't play.
Nope.
Unless it was a blowout. So I was a scrub. So my thought was, now, if I'm going to go to high school and compete when we have three middle schools going into this high school and I can't play at a middle school, how in the world am I going to compete at the high school when all the other stars from other schools get there? So I had to go to work. I had to work hard. I had to put in that time, the extra work, because I wasn't always the best athlete. I wasn't always the fastest guy. That was not my makeup. So I get to high school, I get to ninth grade, I end up starting on offense. That's fine. I didn't really want to start on offense, but at least I'm playing now.
Are you going to keep looking?
My sophomore year, I end up going both ways. Well, I went both ways because our better athletes, better sophomores, went to varsity. So guess what? There was room for me to play another spot. So anyway, my junior year, I put in all that work, all that time in the weight room, running in the summertime, running heels, just to get better. I ended up starting my junior year. Okay, that's good. My senior year came. I started, I was all state, we ended up with state, 16-0. I don't know if any of y'all remember this game, but there was a game called this Plano East versus John Tyler. It was when we were up 42-17 with 2 minutes and 55 seconds left, and they came back, and they left, kicked the ball deep, we ran back for a touchdown, ain't no winning. I was on that team. So we won the ESPY Award. We're still on ESPN to this day. I wake up sometimes and it's on TV. It's one of the biggest high school games they ever played. So I'll play that game. But anyway, I wrote a letter to myself and said, you know what? When I go to Tech, I want to be drafted in 1999 draft. I want to start 75% of my time at Tech. I wrote that letter. It was a goal that I said. So I went to Tech. I'm going through this. I got to get to my point. I went to Tech, I ended up starting my sophomore year. I had injuries for my first year. I ended up starting my sophomore year. My junior year, I had a good year. With what you have, and know this, you work that because what you're going through, God is going to get the glory. Because people look at you and they wonder, why? But guess what you do? You keep pressing on. You go to Special Olympics. You compete. You ain't worried about nobody else. Y'all come here tonight.
Are you Carlos?
Y'all just like everybody else have a banquet. So what?
That's you have your own banquet. Carlos?
You get recognized. That's fine. That's fine. Hey, nobody else. Right now, you are who you are because God made you like that. Now, what you gotta do is change your paradigm and accept who you are. Deal with what you have. And say, you know what? God bless me with who I am today. And I'm going to live it to the fullest. That's all I'd like to say. Thank you guys for inviting me out.
got. Look, I'm hungry right now. But your work, she's working. She's so committed to making a successful album that she forgets to eat.
I heard you. I don't really say
that. Don't say that's life for a living. But Floyd Mayweather retired 49-0. What people don't know is work ethic. Floyd Mayweather will promote at the club, doesn't touch alcohol or anything else, and he'll call his people up and say, hey, it's 3 o'clock in the morning, I know, but open up the gym. I got to get better. I know this guy is asleep right now. I know my opponent is asleep right now. So open the gym up. I want to work out. Just the other night, last week, the Celtics were playing the Wizards, game 6. And I'm working on a project right now, and I'm trying to make it successful. And the Celtics were playing the Wizards. It was a close game, about 3 or 4 minutes left in the game. But something was bothering me. I hadn't worked on my project yet all day. It was a Friday night, but I was still feeling bad. I hadn't worked on my project all day. I said, it's a hard decision, but I'm going to cut the game off, and I'm going to do a little something on my project. So I cut the game off, worked on my project, and the Wizards won in the last second three-pointer. I missed it, but I was cool with it because I knew my purpose was to make my project successful. And so whatever you do, look, you have to make sacrifices. I know the students, I know you, Snapchat, Facebook, Instagram, all that. But look, like I said, Devontae has so much potential. And like anytime we have any kind of event where we have to cook food, I say, okay, I know I got skills in cooking. So just y'all let me cook, and I'm gonna do my thing, and y'all just stay inside. Devontae always comes the next day with some spices in the bag. He said, no, trust me. Muhammad, if you put these spices on, it's gonna taste a whole lot better. So I put the spices on, and I said, Devontae, you know what? You didn't lie. It tastes a whole lot better. So I know the potential that these students have. I have another student. Disco. Stand up for me. Disco Daniel.
Okay, cool.
You say you're greatest at basketball, you gotta work on your footwork, right? He said, well, I know everything. I said, okay, look up Hakeem Olajuwon. Hakeem Olajuwon is the greatest, he has the greatest footwork in the history of basketball. He's a big man, but guards used to go to him to learn how to make the right footwork move. Mm-hmm. Oh, he said, okay, I'm gonna go home and study. So he went home, and the next day, Michael had everything down pat of what Hakeem Olajuwon used to do. He had all of it. Man, I'm Mr. Muhammad, I do the dream shake. I know how to do this and this. Mr. Muhammad, I said, how you learn all this stuff? He knew his stats. He knew the games that he had that were bad. He knew everything. He knew the opponents that gave him problems on the basketball court.
Yep.
It was amazing. And I had a student last year who, he had these elaborate plays that was written out. He had a book of elaborate plays that was written out. It was amazing. And Grant Green, you too. Grant Green is the tech man. Grant Green, anything that I need, hey Grant, how'd you do this with your phone? I have an iPhone too. How can I do this? And Grant just showed me. It's amazing to me. So all these kids have so much potential. Never let the limitations that man put on you interfere with your God-given limitations. I'm gonna give a couple of little small stories in my. When I first got left college, I was just like anybody else. I wasn't sure what I was gonna do.